the skills that they've picked up in a different genre, in a different style of game, even in sort of mobile, you know, it all crosses over. And they'll come in and they'll be like, well, I don't really understand Formula One. It's like, you'll get it. You'll be working with a team that knows so much about the sport, that are so passionate about
it
the sport.
It just becomes infectious.
It'll rub off, yeah.
Yeah. So I wanted to ask, you know, we've been talking a little bit about the competitive scene, but for people who've never played an F1 game before, what do you have to assure those players that it won't be too complicated, that it's not too simulation heavy, and what's the kind of barrier to
But it scales incredibly well as well. Mm-hmm. So, you know, at the easy end of the scale, you know, the game can apply the brakes for you. We've got traction control, ABS. And then at the hardcore end of the scale, there's no hand-holding at all.
Yeah.
You know, incredibly difficult. Also, you've got things to worry about, like the fuel weights, the tire temperatures, tire wear, weather conditions. You know, so it scales really well. And I think that's something that, at an event like this, for example, you get a lot of people who maybe haven't played the game, and they play it, and they're pleasantly surprised how they can actually adapt. One of the strong things I've had back in the last couple of days has been, you do a couple of laps and you're like, this is difficult.
Mm-hmm.
You do three or four laps and you start to get into a flow,
and then
it just clicks. And you don't realize when it happens, all of a sudden, you're flying around consistently. Yeah, we're having a great time.
It must be really cool to see that. Like,